name is Robin Lambert. I'm 19 years old and living with cerebral palsy, but you guys know me as the T-Rex and you're watching My T-Rex Life. Okay guys, this morning I saw Annie's video on the body image tag, which I will link down below, and that kind of just inspired me this morning to say, yep, that's what I'm doing, so thanks for getting me to do something, Annie. So anyway, let's get right into it. You're attractive, and do you think you're traditionally slash mainstreamly attractive? Okay, to answer that, I think I do okay. I think I'm pretty attractive. Because to me, being attractive is not necessarily about physical attributes. It's about embracing who you are and being true to yourself. And I think generally, I tend to do that. And I think, you know, like I said, it's not all about the physical, it's about how you can pull yourself together and the image that you can put out for other people and, you know, what you have to offer people. I think I do okay. You know, people tell me I'm attractive. Two pretty good looking parents, so I guess I've been gifted with that. Tell me, do you think I'm attractive? Okay, as for the second part of that question, do you think you're traditionally slash mainstreamly attractive? Perhaps not so much. I mean, as a female, I don't think I adhere to the traditional ideals of femininity as much, so I guess you could say that might not be as attractive to some people in the mainstream sense. And I'm also disabled, which, as we know, is not represented as adequately as it should be within the media, so I don't think it's, you know, quite caught on to everyone that, you know, disability can be beautiful and attractive. So, you know, whilst I think I'm pretty attractive and, you know, there's other people that might agree with me, I'm not for everyone, but hey, who is? So, yeah. The second question is, what was your biggest insecurity as a teenager? What is your biggest insecurity now? And how has your body image changed? Okay, so for me, there were two things that I was a little bit insecure about as a teenager. Well, I'm still a teenager, but as a younger teenager. And the first one was my duck bum. Because I have CP, my hip flexors are pretty tight, and my flexibility isn't great, so when I'm doing my little waddle and I'm stood up, I have a little bit of a duck bum, which I didn't think looked particularly great in all outfits, and, you know, it was particularly attractive. And the second thing was, you know, for someone who didn't feel traditionally feminine, I felt like, you know, that was something I should be adhering to, but didn't know how, and that was all very confusing to me, and I didn't feel like it was particularly attractive. But as of now, I don't really have any significant insecurities. I mean, we all have those days where we're like, damn, I wish my stomach was more toned, and, you know, I wish I didn't have this pimple on my face, and I wish my hair was just gonna work for me. But like, I feel like I've really grown into myself, and I've developed like a new confidence, and I know that I don't have to have long hair and long legs and, you know, want to wear dresses all the time, and I don't have to have like a perfectly aligned body to be beautiful and to be attractive. I just have to be myself, and people will pick up on that, and that's what makes people, you know, find you attractive, is if you have a good personality and you present yourself well to them, and, you know, you're being true to yourself. Well, that's what I believe anyway. I think anyone can be beautiful, and you know, anyone can be attractive. You have to put some effort in, right? Like, you have to, you know, you have to think about the way you're presenting yourself, and, you know, you have to tidy yourself up and everything. But, I mean, yeah, I honestly believe anyone can be attractive. And, you know, for me, I have a certain body type that, you know, a certain body that I want to achieve. Everyone has goals, though, right? And, so for me, that means going to the gym and trying to build muscle and just trying to be the best version of myself that I can be. But everyone's idea of beauty and attractiveness is different, and I think, you know, you just got to strive to be the best version of yourself. Third question is, how does style play into your body image? And if you saw my video yesterday, which I will link down below, you'll know that style plays a huge part in my body image. For me, as long as I'm fit and healthy, you know, what happens under my clothes is of the least importance to me. It's how on fleek my outfit is looking and how I'm pulling that off and, you know, how I've created that top look. But I mean, we all dress to accentuate the parts of our bodies that we find attractive or we find interesting and to hide the parts that we don't like so much, but that's just natural. But to me, you know, I'm often personally attracted to the way people pull themselves together and the look that they're trying to create and how they're being true to themselves far more than what their face looks like or, you know, what size they are or whatever. And, you know, that's me personally, but I know a lot of people believe that too. So, yeah, for me, style is a huge part of it. For me, you know, through my style, I get to show people who I am. And, you know, I get to influence the way that they perceive me. So style is hugely important for me. It always has been. Question number four is, how do you define beauty? And when do you feel most beautiful? For me, I just define beauty as being true to yourself and, you know, taking care of yourself and showing people what you have to offer. And, you know, it's not just about your physical attributes, it's about, you know, how kind you are and how much you help others and how considerate you are. I am really attracted to uniqueness, personally, you know, but that's just me. And like I said, yeah, for me, personality is far more important than looks, but for me, I feel most beautiful when I'm with my friends, because they accept me regardless of whether I've got, you know, a giant pimple on my face, whether I've got a scent of parting, you know, whatever. You know, they might laugh at me, but I laugh at them just as much. And they have laughed at certain outfits, I guess. But yeah, they accept me, and the same with my family, you know. I also feel most beautiful after I've just worked out, because I know that I'm working towards, you know, what I want to achieve for myself. I also feel beautiful when I'm creating things, because, you know, I'm making something that is a part of me, to show the world. And, you know, I feel most beautiful when my biceps are looking decent and my jawline's looking sharp and my hair's doing what it's supposed to do. You know, all the usual things. But I think, yeah, the message for me is just to own who you are, to be true to yourself and to just rock you, because we're all meant to be individuals, we're all meant to be unique. That's why we all come out different, some more funny looking than others. Jokes. So yeah, you're all beautiful, you're all attractive. As for who I want to tag in this video, I think if you're watching this and you want to do the tag, just do it, because who am I to tell who to do this tag or not? So go for it. But most importantly, guys, let me know your comments and your thoughts in the comment section down below. And remember to stay shiny, because I love you.